Welcome to your guide to the dark web. The dark web is a part of the internet that is not indexed by search engines. It operates on websites that are essentially hidden behind secure browsers. Gaining access requires using special software. This makes it much more difficult for cyber criminals to steal users' personal information or engage in other crimes. However, many people use the dark web to purchase illicit drugs or weapons, making it an extremely delicate subject. The deep web refers to websites that are inaccessible through search engines because they are encrypted and not found with regular website addresses. Here are 10 things you need to know about dark web. Number 1. What is the dark web? The dark web is a part of the internet that is not indexed by search engines and which many people believe to be the playground for hackers and cyber crooks. They're often right. The dark net hosts an enormous range of illegal content, from drugs and weapons to child pornography. The so-called Tor network encrypts communications, hides IP addresses, and protects information from surveillance. Number 2. How to access the dark web. The dark web is an area on the internet that allows people to hide behind pseudonyms to conduct illegal activities. From weapons deals, human trafficking, assassinations, drug deals, you name it. But these things are possible thanks to Tor Onion Services, a technology that makes the dark web accessible. Learn how it works and what you need to know about this section of the internet. Number 3. Does the government control the dark web? A lot of people believe the government may control the dark web, but there is no proof for this. The IP addresses will show up as a series of numbers and letters when using the Tor browser, and even advanced scanning tools can't uncover private information. It's hard to say whom they control it because it's not possible to know who is behind an IP address or what their intentions are. Number 4. Can you access dark web using a VPN? Using a VPN is very popular on the dark web, and this is one of the many ways to access it. It's possible to surf anonymously and protect your identity, but this doesn't guarantee that hackers or the government won't be able to access any private information you may post or browse. VPNs can be used with Tor. But there are also browsers dedicated specifically to the dark web such as Oxbow and Onion browser. Number 5. Why would anyone use it? Some people are understandably resistant to the idea of journaling. They might feel that they are not unique enough, or are too busy, or are not ready for this kind of thing. But there is no harm in trying it out. All you have to do is pick up a pen and write down your thoughts. You can try journaling for just 30 seconds a day. Give it a time period that works for you, whether that's every day, every week, or once a month, and see where it takes you. Just like anything else, journaling can sometimes be used for illicit purposes. When you journal, you might share your ideas with people who don't care about your well-being and safety, people who might secretly use this information to harm you. Some people might even use the information they've gathered for their own personal gain. You should never give your journaling data to anyone that you don't trust. Number 6. What can and cannot be done on the dark web? The dark web is a tricky place. On one hand, it contains some of the deepest parts of the internet, making it a hub for hackers and drug cartels alike. But it also has some interesting benefits you can take advantage of without having to go through any aforementioned mess. For example, you could purchase stolen credit card numbers or even find out people's personal information in your community. You can do all that and more on the dark web. If you're the type of person who wants to go into the deep end of the internet, then dark web will be right up your alley. Plus, thanks to the Onion router, Tor network, you'll never have to worry about law enforcement trying to track you down. Sure, there are some things that can't be done on the dark web, but one of the most common misconceptions about it is that it's nothing but illegal activities. Number 7. What can be found on the dark web? The dark web is a subset of the internet that you can only access with special software like Tor. The dark web includes sites like Silk Road, which was taken down by law enforcement in 2013 and again in 2014. Hanza Market, where over 350 drug shipments were seized earlier this year, and Dream Market, which took on Silk Road's business after it shuttered. Number 8. What is Tor? Why does it matter? Many people use Tor's browser to keep their internet activity anonymous. That might be because they value their privacy, but also because they fear repression. Tor is a great way to avoid surveillance and network restrictions, such as censorship and throttling of services like social media or browsing the web. Tor is a free-to-use, volunteer-run service that provides anonymity by hiding who you are online. It can be used for both good and bad reasons to achieve unwanted outcomes either way, so it's important for it to be properly monitored if we want to ensure the service remains free from misuse without jeopardizing its main purpose of helping those in need do good things online safely. Number 9. Are there any risks involved with using the dark web? websites that are not accessible via usual browser. Examples of these sites include Tor hidden services, I2P websites, and freenet websites. These types of websites provide anonymity for their users and can be used to host illegal or questionable activities such as online criminal activity. The dark web is the most widely distributed part of the onion routing network of computer networks on the internet, which utilizes cryptographic techniques to hide its users' identities. It has been estimated that there are more than 45,000 active servers in this hidden network, with thousands more added each month. Number 10. Is it safe to use the dark web, or should I just stay off of it altogether? In an age where it's been said that privacy is luxury and everyone is constantly being watched, it becomes more important to figure out the balance of convenience and safety. While there are plenty of what-ifs and worst-case scenarios that could arise from the dark web, most users can rest easy knowing they, and their information, will remain safe and secure. If you did enjoy our video, please press the like button and subscribe. Thanks.